Welcome to KEX Construction Engineering. Today, we are going to learn how to do setting out using 3-for-5 or square method. Before we proceed, let's answer this. What is setting out? In simple and practical terms, setting out is the process of transferring design information accurately from paper drawings onto the ground as planned and designed. Basic tools and materials: 1. Builder's square. 2. Measuring tape. 3. Wood pegs. 4. Hammer. 5. Nails. 6. String lines. 7. Plumb. 8. Marker. 9. Plumb bob. 10. Building plan. Now, let's move to site. As we proceed, you can ask me any question you want on this. Let's follow the building plan below. Foundation layout. Positioning of the first peg. Plumb to ensure it is 90 degrees upward. It is important to do so to ensure accuracy in measurement. Taking measurement from the first point to the second point to establish the reference line AB. 3.2 meters distance between grid line A and B. Measuring from the second peg to the third. 3.2 meters distance between grid line 1 and 2. Ensure you pause and view the drawing carefully so you can understand the dimensions used here. Using the builder's square to square line off and BC to 90 degrees. meters distance between grid line A and B. Adjust the end of the line at point C till it align with the square. Positioning the fourth peg at point D. Hammer it firmly into the ground. Taking measurement from point C to D. Connect them with string line. For accuracy, ensure the lines are well tensioned. Squaring the second corner at point C. If you love what I am doing here, like and share my work. I upload construction video every week. Stay tuned for more weekly videos and feel free to ask question. I will always reply. Thanks. Confirm the distance between point A and D if equals line BC. If the measurement are the same, the work is accurate. Line BC equals AD equals 3.2 meters. Good, but we still need to confirm the two diagonals AC and BD. Good job, the diagonals are equal. You can also calculate to reconfirm it using Pythagorean rule. Transferring the same setting to the bigger space rectangle in the drawing. Squaring the corners properly. Note, you must view the square and measurement tape from the right direction to avoid error due to parallax. Confirm the diagonal CF and EG. Good, the diagonals are equal. Now, ready to construct setting out profile so we can transfer our points and lines to it. To 0.2 meters given as distance of the profile from the building outer grid lines. Note, give sufficient distance that will ensure the safety of your profile during and after excavation. Driving pegs into the ground firmly. (800 millimeters) is the distance between the pegs. Constructing and maintaining the same offset and alignment of the building. If you love what I am doing here, like and share my work. I upload construction video every week. Stay tuned for more weekly videos and feel free to ask question. I will always reply. Thanks. Profile construction completed. Now, let's start transferring the grid lines to the profile, starting with our refrunk line AB. Transferring the first grid line 1 carefully to the profile. Mark the point and put a nail. From the same reference line AB, extend the same grid line 1 to the opposite side of the profile. Mark the point and put a nail. Having transferred the first grid line 1 successfully, let us bring out our drawing and start offsetting the rest grid lines. From the drawing, offset 3.2 meters from grid line 1 to get grid line 2. Now extend the line to the measured point on the profile and add a nail. From the drawing, offset for 0.2 meters from grid line 2 to get grid line 3. Extend the string line to the measured point on the profile. In the same manner, offset 3.6 meters from grid line 3 to get grid line 4. Extend the line to the nail on the profile. Then confirm if the final grid line is aligned with the initial set out points. In the same manner, use the same approach to establish the rest grid lines as given in the drawing. Now all the grid lines have been established on the profile successfully. Let's reconfirm the perpendicularity of the corners before removing the inner points and pegs ahead of excavation. If you love what I am doing here, like and share my work. I upload construction video every week. Stay tuned for more weekly videos and feel free to ask question. I will always reply. Thanks. Now, let's confirm everything we have done so far before we start marking out the trenches. My professional advice at this point, do not be tired of checking and reconfirming your measurement, because later it will be too expensive to correct any mistake made at this stage. Good. Let's start marking out the trench and block wall width. 225 millimeters is the block wall width. Offset 112.5 millimeters to the left and right of the center line and put nails. 675 millimeters is the width of the trench. Offset 337.5 millimeters to the left and right of the center line and put nails. Fix string lines to the trench nails and run it to the opposite grid line. Do the same at grid line 2 and other grid lines as we jump to the last grid line to save time. (225 millimeters) is the block wall width. Offset 112.5 millimeters to the left and right of the center line and put nails. 675 millimeters is the width of the trench. Offset 337.5 millimeters to the left and right of the center line and put nails. Fix string lines to the trench nails and run it to the opposite grid line. Note, all the lines must be tensioned to ensure accurate measurement and marking. Having fixed all the trench lines correctly, let us start tracing and marking them on the ground so that excavation can commence. This marking on the ground can be done using sand or sawdust to trace the trench outlines. If you love what I am doing here, like and share my work. I upload construction video every week. Stay tuned for more weekly videos and feel free to ask question. I will always reply. Thanks. People use different methods that work for them to mark the foundation base. This is one of the best manual method. You can try it on your site. This involves using a wooden frame of the same dimension with the base and align it using plumb bob. Do the same at all the base points. Ready for excavation. Excavation in progress. Excavation of 1.5 meters depth pad foundation completed. General inspection of the work done so far. If you love what I am doing here, like and share my work. I upload construction video every week. Stay tuned for more weekly videos and feel free to ask question. I will always reply. Thanks. This is how to manually set out a building using square or 3x5 method. Thanks for watching.